Welcome to the testing world. So in previous sessions, we have seen how we can fetch data from the table. Now I'll show you how we can delete data from the table. For deleting the data, we have three commands. One is delete, other one is truncate, and third one is drop. So I'll show you all these operations and I'll show you the difference between them. But first of all, what I'll do, and you also do the same thing, first create few more tables which we can delete, because if you delete these tables you cannot practice further. So what I'm doing, just use the same query which I'm doing. I have a table with the name customers. I want to create copy of this, so I'm writing create table customer 1 as select star from customers. Please use the same query, it will create one more table customer 1 as a copy of customers. And how this query is working, I'll cover up in the further session for when we go for how to create tables. But as of now, I'm just making the copy of it. I'm just running it. So once you execute it, just go to your schema and you have the option of refresh. So you will get one more table with the name customers. This table will be created and all the data of this customer table will be copied to this customer 1. In the same way I do here, I'll just create one more copy of employees. So I'm saying employees 1 and select star from employees. So I'm just creating few copies of the table so that I can delete the data of these tables. It is executed. If you want, again check, refresh, we got one table with the name employees 1. And I make a copy of this offices as well. So I'll just make a copy like create table offices 1 select star from offices. So I'm just executing it. We got one more table, refresh, offices 1. If you want to check data of these newly created table, you can check it like select star from customer 1. Running, we'll get the data of it. In the same way, you can write it like employees 1. I should get data. Same, I will show you offices 1. We have some data. Now, first I want to show you delete command. With the help of the delete command, we can delete data of the table conditionally. So conditionally means if I want to delete, okay, if I have a table like this, I'm just fetching the data of employees table, employees 1 table. Okay, I want to delete data from this employees table where my job title is sales representative. So we can delete the data from the table by using delete command conditionally. We can pass condition. So I'm saying delete from employees 1 where job title is sales REP. So if I run this query, okay, when I run this, if you check it here, we are getting an error message. You are using a safe mode, update mode, so you cannot do that. Okay, that's not the query issue. Actually, we'll have to go to the edit preferences, and here we have query data. Here in the workbench preferences, go to the SQL editor. There you will get at the bottom safe update checkbox. So by default it will reject your update and delete query. I want to remove this checkbox. Okay, after making changes, I'll just need to close this and again connect with the database. So I'm just connecting with the database again. I've just pasted the same queries again. Now select this delete, run. So it is executed successfully. Okay, if it is executed successfully, now let me select the date of the employees table. I'm running it. So if you notice, this time we are getting only few records. Other records where job title was sales representative is removed. So now if you notice, we have executed delete query successfully. So we are saying delete from table name, and this is the condition we are giving condition. So with the help of the delete, we can conditionally delete data from the table. But if you notice, we are deleting the data, not the table structure. Table is still there. Okay, one more thing I want to show you. If I write like this, delete from employees 1. Now, if I execute it, will it execute? Answer is yes. Here we are not giving condition. So what will happen if you are running a delete query without giving a condition? In that case, it will delete complete data of the table. So if you are giving condition, it will delete according to the condition. But if you don't give any condition, it will delete complete data from the table. So let me run this select query again. And if you notice, the table is there. We have these columns, but there is no data inside the table. So I can say with the help of the delete, we can delete the data from the table, maybe conditionally or unconditionally. If you are giving condition, only data which satisfies the condition will be deleted. But if we don't give condition, complete data of the table will be deleted, but table is there, means structure of the table is not deleted. If you want to check, you can check it here. Like I'm just refreshing, you will notice table is still there. We can check by running the query as well. Table is there, data is not there. That is delete. Next, I'm coming to truncate. Truncate is also used to delete data from the table unconditionally. Means we cannot give any condition. So what I'm doing, I'm fetching data of the customer one table. So I'm saying select star from customers one and just execute. So if you notice, that is the data of the customer one. I want to delete complete data of this table. So I can use like truncate table, and what was the table name? Customer one. Truncate query is used to completely delete the data of the table. So we cannot put any condition. Running, that is done. If that is done, let's run this select query again. So if you notice, data is removed, structure is there, means the table structure is still there, but data of the table is removed, is deleted. So I can say with the help of the delete, we can delete the data conditionally or unconditionally, but with the help of the truncate, we can delete complete data of the table. Still, you can notice structure is there, means structure is not deleted. Last, I'm coming to drop. So drop is similar to the truncate. So first of all, let me show you data from offices table, offices one. So that is my offices one. We have a lot of data. I want to delete data of this table as well as table structure. Means in the previous two queries, you have noticed in case of the delete and truncate, data was deleted, but the structure was there. Structure means table is there. We can again insert the data on the table in that table later. But if you want to delete the data as well as table, we can use drop. So I'm saying drop table, and the table name is offices one. Just running it, executed successfully. If you notice, the table is removed from here. Also, if you want to check, you can try to run the select query. It will throw you error. Here you can check error. The offices one does not exist. So here, if you notice, with the help of drop command, drop query, we are deleting data as well as table structure. So for rest of the queries like delete and truncate, data was deleting, table structure was there. Means we can reuse the table later on. But here in the drop, data as well as table structure is deleted. So if I come here, I can say delete, truncate, drop, all can delete data. Delete command can delete data conditionally. Truncate and drop delete unconditionally. Delete and truncate does not remove structure of the table, but drop remove structure as well. Also, we have few more differences. Delete is a DML. All the queries that we are having can be distributed in DDL commands, DML, DRL. So we have these sections. So I'm saying delete is a DML command. DML command are the command which are working on the data. Working on the data means we are inserting data, we are updating data, we are deleting data. So that is DML commands. DDL commands are the commands which are working on the table. How we can identify which one is the DDL and which one is the DML? So whenever we are writing query, if in the query you are using this table word, by this table you can understand that's a DDL, means that's a working on table. And other command, if it is not select, so other commands are called DML, which are working on the data. Select command are called DRL. So these are data retrieval. DDL means data definition language, and DML means data manipulation. So wherever you are getting table, it's a DDL. So you can take it as a difference like these two, truncate and drop. If you see the structure of these queries, truncate table, drop table, we are getting this table word. These are DDL. And if you check it here in the delete, we are not getting this word. If you check it here in the delete, we are not getting table word. That's a DML. DML means queries working on the data of the table. Now, last difference I will tell you, can be revert or rollback. What does it mean? Okay, I would say you can identify the difference between the DDL and DML. DDL command cannot be rollback, means once you have executed, data is finalized, means it is automatically saved. But DML are not auto commit. Not auto commit means if you perform this DML, later on you think, okay, I have done the mistake, I want to revert, you can do that. So this delete is a DML which can be rollback, but truncate and drop are DDL command, and DDL command cannot be rollback. These are the three differences of delete, drop and truncate. Try to execute all these queries very carefully, because this is deleting the data. Also, in interviews you are going to face this question, what is the difference between delete, drop and truncate? So here we have seen what is delete, drop and truncate. That's all we have for this session. Thanks for watching this video.